Know-how is what separates leaders who perform, who deliver results, from those who don't. It is the hallmark of people who know what they are doing, those who build long-term intrinsic value and hit the short-term targets. Hello everyone and welcome to Avid Wisdom. Here is the summary of the book called Know-how, the skills that separate people who perform from those who don't, by Ram Charan. If you are a startup or a leader in any firm, or just a curious person who wants to know what it takes to run a business, watch this video till the end. You will have some great insights from this book. Before we continue, please make sure you subscribe to my channel and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you never miss an update. Hit the like button if you like this video. It is one thing to start a business, but it is altogether a different thing to run a business. Certainly, intelligence, self-confidence, presence, the ability to communicate and have a vision are important, but being highly intelligent doesn't mean that a person has the knack of making good business judgments. How many times have you seen people confidently making decisions that turn out to be disastrous? How often have you heard a vision that turn out to be nothing more than rhetoric and hot air? Personal attributes are just one small slice of the leadership pie, and their value is greatly diminished without know-how. The 8 interrelated skills that bring leadership into the realm of profit and loss. Aspiring business leaders don't set out to do a lousy job, but it happens. Young people learn quickly what they have to do to be recognized. Impress others with their intelligence, fast thinking and commanding presence. Over time, they polish all the outward appearance of leadership and their superior by it lock, stock and barrel. It seems incredible when it comes to business leadership. We don't consider the most important piece of it. Does this person have the know-how to succeed? Is he or she capable of developing them? Know-how are learned, developed through the practice and honed through the experience. Leaders who are disciplined, determined, consistent and persistent in developing these know-how tends to be successful on a sustainable basis. In that sense, leaders are born. The 8 know-hows. Number 1. Positioning and repositioning. Finding a central idea for business that meets customers' demand and that makes money. The frequency, depth and abruptness of change in the world today means that you will be frequently shaping and reshaping your business so that it fits with the ever-changing landscape in a way that delivers your money-making aspiration. Knowing how to position and reposition a business is among the most demanding requirements of the 21st century leaders. Number 2. Pinpointing external changes. Detecting patterns in a complex world to put the business on the offensive. You need to spread the net wide, then do the mental processing to identify the underlying patterns. You need an unstable curiosity and interest in the world and an intense drive to find out what you don't know. It is the know-how of pinpointing external changes that allows you to make a sound judgment about where the world is going. Number 3. Leading the social system. Getting the right people together with the right behavior and the right information to make better, faster decisions and achieve business results. A biggest untapped opportunity for your success as a leader is shaping the way people work together to deliver the numbers. Your own performance depends on your ability to get other people to commit and deliver their common goals. Number 4. Judging people. Collaborating people based on their action, decision and behavior and matching them to the non-negotiable of the job. The usual way of developing other people's leadership talent is to start with a job opening and see who can fill it. But the know-how is selecting the leaders and helping them reach their potential means focusing on people first, not job. You can't afford to lock into unrealistic positive or negative views of people, thinking he can do no right or she can do no wrong, and discounting information to the contrary. People grow and change and jobs continually evolve, so you have to be psychologically open to continuously update your judgment on people. Number 5. Molding a team. The biggest challenge as a leader is molding these high energy, high powered, high ego people into working team of leaders who synchronize their efforts and propel the business forward. Number 6. Setting goals. Determine the set of goals that balance what the business can become with what it can realistically achieve. Many people think setting goals is simple and straightforward, but in fact, selecting the right set of goals is the ultimate juggling act. The goals have to be the right type and magnitude to be both achievable as well as motivational. They have to be accepted by investors who usually think of short-term goals, but also ensure that the business can make money in long term. Number 7. Setting laser sharp priorities. Defining the path and aligning resources, action and energy to accomplish the goals. When you select priorities, you have to choose among 4 criteria. What is important? What is urgent? What is long term versus short term? And what is realistic versus visionary? If you don't make choices among them because you want to do everything, the result will be muddled. You need to have the psychological conviction to choose the right balance among them. Number 8. Dealing with forces beyond the market. Anticipating and responding to social pressures you don't control but that can affect your business. The challenge is to keep abreast of changing social expectations and adapt your business accordingly, while avoiding landmines. Many special interest groups raises legitimate issues and you need to understand and respond to them. Bear in mind that pressure from outside groups has led to many social benefits. Let me conclude this video by saying, remember that success is never final. That's a fact 21st century leaders cannot escape. You will have to make a commitment to your ongoing personal growth. I urge you to do as if the faith of the world depends on it, because in a way it does. The country's economic standards are not made by economic theories or inventions or technologies. It is made by leaders. Hope you like this video. If you did, please hit the like button and comment down below if you have any suggestions. Share this video with your friends and do subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that you never miss an update. See you till the next video. Till then, take care. Bye.